afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another stream from our channel. Today we will fly new HondaJet version 106, and we'll do two short hops. One is from Belgrade airport in Serbia to Sarajevo airport, and then we'll refuel there, leave some baggage, and continue our trip to Salzburg airport. Hopefully they fixed some issues we had with avionics, but that's probably the only thing that needed fixing that I saw, and everything else I was quite satisfied with the way airplane is flying and everything else. So let's hop into the cockpit and start our flight. Yeah, before we do that, I'm still thinking about two airplanes to start basically a world tour. One is TBM 930 because I like that plane, and the second one is really this Honda Jet. I never did a tour in, let's say, a jet plane, but we can try it if minimum equipment is working as we are asking. So just give me a second. Let's go inside the cockpit and start this nice little airplane.
Oral warning. Okay.
We have ground power. One thing that is very nice about this plane is that in new update they let's say airplane doesn't forget how you left them. So if you left doors open, ground power connected,
pause
and everything,
system test. Okay.
He actually accepts that. So let's go and check. Yeah, we need 1,700 pounds of fuel. Only one pilot, and let's go to initialization so pre-flight can be done before we enter. And the airplane, Microsoft thinks that I'm that light, but I'm not. Okay, we have zero passengers. And we have, let's just verify how much cargo we have. 1.5. Okay. Fuel is what we actually need. And that's it. Let's next, we'll get from sim our beat speeds. So we are rotating at 113 knots. This is something they still didn't fix, because you're unable to change frequency, or I mean you can, but the thing is that when I put something in standby, when I click up, it should automatically go there, but on this screen it's not working. on the screen is working. Let's see, 2000. And it's changed, it's on standby, and we can enter our flight plan. But before we do that, we'll connect to Vatsim network, since we always fly on Vatsim. And let's just verify if by any chance we have ATC. Yeah, we still have ATC in Sarajevo. Just give me a second to verify something else. And that is our call sign. This is standard call sign that we are using, or something different. Yeah, it's a standard one. And let's get connected to Vatsim network. We're done. So our origin is Belgrade Airport, and our destination is Sarajevo. For departure, we'll use runway 12. And the Valjevo 2 Foxtrot departure. Okay, we'll load departure. I think I clicked. Let's do it again. Yeah. And for arrival, maybe we can verify with. Sarajevo went offline, unfortunately. So we'll use Kilo Echo Bravo 1 Alpha. 1 Alpha for runway 11. Load. And for approach, we'll use key. Okay, and load that too. And let's go to this. So VNAV is enabled, and we'll see how it's working. Okay. For now, that's it. We have plenty of fuel. Sky is cleaning up because it was very dark and didn't look very nice. Just hold on for a second. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, some private interruptions. Now we can set up basically everything. So our climb, our altitude for Sarajevo will be 22,000 feet. It's refusing to make it higher, yeah. It's lagging. Why? Can I enter this now? It starts working and then stopped again. Is it 15 or something more? That could be a problem when we are descending. Okay. So minimums are second. Minimums are for Sarajevo. Six, five, seven. Enter. Really? Nice. Okay. We need our speeds, that's something that I wanted. What's that? Okay. Okay. Utilities initialization is not that. Performance speedbugs, so VR is 113 and V2 120, 15. Let's see if this also. No, it's working. Oh, it's not working. It's not updating correctly. So we don't know actual speed. That can be issue. Well, let's give it a chance. Which mode? Normal anti-ice we don't need. Everything is okay. Let's close the door. We can disconnect external power. Close the door. And let's start engine 2. Let's wait a little bit for engine to stabilize and then we'll start engine number one. Let's call locals. Belgrade traffic, King Uniform, 9000 Hotel on General Aviation Apron, starting up engines, Belgrade. Stable. Let's start first one, PFD settings. Altitude units. Something, come on. Can we? It's froze. Okay, PFD. other altitude units. Okay, back. It doesn't actually give you option to see here what you're changing, just show there. Graphics never worked. Sorry. Okay. Active navigation, we are too. It's very slow for some strange reason. I don't know what's going on, but hopefully it will work when we need it. For today's flight, we'll use runway 12. So let's see. All lights are off, beacon and navigation are on, which is good. Let's see if we'll start taxiing. Lights on when we start. Heading was very slow and it's still slow. We need to enter one. Come on. Okay, flight director is on. We'll use heading. Okay. So let's go. Belgrade traffic, Yankee Uniform 9 Tower Hotel, taxiing to Honey Point Runway 12. Belgrade. We'll not put any flaps right away, we'll put them when we approach the runway. Please, this is moving correctly. So let's go. And taxi lights are on, so it's working. And of course, altimeter for today's flight is 1017. And it's not changing. I hope it's correct now. Yes, it is. Well, actually, these airplanes are never here, but who knows? Maybe. And we can set transponder to TA only. see, we have guest message. Oh, cabin power on. Let's give power to the people. See if we can record this flight. Composed. First notch of flaps for takeoff. Belgrade traffic, Yankee Uniform 9 Hotel. Entering runway 12 for takeoff. Belgrade traffic. Let's see. Landing lights are not on. Should be on. Also recognition lights, strobe lights, nothing is on. So we entered the runway and we still don't have those lights. Let's run. So 11 Belgrade. Okay, let's start out pilot, yo dumper, go to navigation. Oh, accidentally turned off yo dumper. flight level change and speed select to 2. The whole screen froze for a moment. You see? This is not very good. Landing off, recognition, those lights are on. Land. Yeah, this is something that I actually don't like very much. So still avionics needs improvement. Let's change to standard. I mean, as you can see, simulator is not freezing. We're inside, working everything nice. But avionics are freezing. They didn't do that on last version. Okay, going back, map settings. Okay, flight plan, aviation, just airports. This part, yeah, that can be done. Fuel range, reserve. Okay, weather radar. Usually need some time. So it's freezing all the time, which is not very good. We want it 22,000 feet. And let's see this. This part is actually working correctly. But primary flight display is not very happy to see us. We're above the clouds, and what is also strange is we don't see the around here. Maybe let's see it. Just showing top of climb. As always, if you like my videos, please like, subscribe, and there is small bell that you can press, and whenever I start streaming or publish video, you will be notified. Thousand feet to go. Let's just verify that. Yeah. Let's see if this screen also freezes. No, it's working. So at least we have the screen that will show us what we need to know. And if I recall correctly, we didn't have the what's that? Oh, we have on approach 9,000 feet, blah, blah, blah. Oh, that's very nice. I think that we didn't have that last time. So that's nice. Pity that we don't have anyone in Sarajevo to wait us, but I like this showing the cities. Okay, our current speed is 257, indicated, or Mach 0.584. So it will be relatively short flight, yeah. Let's see if it's showing 16:07 and the current time is 16. To the next waypoint, and we don't have approximate time when we will arrive to our destination, which is bad. I like to see that. This is endurance, it's how much fuel we have till for flying. Messages clear. Unfortunately, there is also no traffic. So we are unable to test that. We are approaching Vatsim. I will leave you to enjoy for a while, and we'll see what will actually happen soon. Also, as I said, please like, subscribe, and select that little bell, so you receive all notifications and everything from our channel. Yeah, we are small channel right now, but hopefully we'll grow. And the only way for us to grow is if you help us. So thank you in advance. And now enjoy the rest of the flight. back. And we are waiting our top of descent. Let's see if airplane calculates. No. For now it does. So let's just visualize our top of descent. I don't see it on the screen, which is strange. It says 7 minutes. We need to put this down to approximately 7,000. And we will start slowing down. Change how the wind is represented. What's this? A synthetic terrain. Let's see if we turn off synthetic terrain. It's still. So it doesn't have anything to do with. And this is not very good since we don't know what we are entering. Late with our descent. And I want to play with lights and be able to enter. Lightning 20,000 feet. We didn't set this to 1013. And the Sarajevo Airport current QNH is 1017 also. We need radius, and this we need to be localizer 110 0.70. And our approach course is 113. Let's slow down a little bit more to give enough time for airplane to lose altitude. Let's see, Bosnia. Thousand 400 is actually 4,200 is the altitude that we need. It's not stopping anymore. That's nice. Who knows what happened? Turn on the landing lights and set 1017 and also here 1017. To initiate approach, but it didn't. Now let's go direct to cab and it will give us direct and activate. Give us a bit more time to descend. Maybe we needed to select approach. But the approach is usually for localizer and everything. Let's reduce our speed. So airplane was supposed to go to approach automatically. I don't know why it didn't do that. We'll continue to reduce self power. In here we actually need performance, speedbox, landing. Selectoral approach 110 15. Okay. One ten actually. Let's slow down slowly. And we're capturing like 18 DME arc from cab. Let's see. I don't know what is online. Approaching 4,500. But we were supposed to be 5,400 here, so we'll currently hold altitude. We need is 113. Let's see if we can select course. Unfortunately not, but hopefully we will be able to set heading to 113 and then we'll hold heading. Also, this is like no. We're starting our turn. Let's make it a little bit bigger. He's still doing DME arc. Still didn't capture localizer. There are no wind data. Let's see if we can other settings. Wind option 3. Supposed to be at 3 was at 5,400, but we didn't. We can slow down a bit more. Doesn't want to select approach because probably the localizer isn't captured. But we have airport in sight almost. we have like 4 nautical miles until final fix. And we can continue our descent to slowly. Let's try approach now and localizer. Waiting for a glide slope to get captured. We can set first notch of flaps. Oh, it's quite heavy on the airplane. Let's see if we can put the gear down while we are at external view. Yes, we can. Very nice. We see your flaps. Let's go inside. Okay, let's go to cockpit. Enough games. Flaps too. Landing lights are on, recognition on, eyes no needed. So basically that's it. When we land, we will take a small break, about few minutes, until I find the flight plan to Salzburg. And we'll, then we will continue our trip to our new destination. So, as I said, if you like what we are doing, please thumbs up, subscribe, and that little bell, and it will greatly help this channel to grow and put more videos. Sarajevo traffic, Yankee Uniform Night on Hotel on short final runway 11, Sarajevo.
Minimums.
Okay.
Autopilot.
We don't need autopilot. And yaw damper off. We'll continue with our landing. Have visual with runway, so that's basically everything we need.
Minimums.
Maybe this is better view. I'm trying to use trim.
500.
We're a slight high.
400. Three hundred. 200. One hundred. 50, 40. 30, 20. 10, 5.
We missed this turn point. I mean, this is like second time in this airplane we are trying to get to know each other a little bit, but I'm sure that after a while there will be no issues with this airplane. Also, it requires very slow for us to go on runway or taxiway slowly because it doesn't want to turn. If I remember correctly, GA parks there. Let's just turn off landing lights, set to normal. Taxi lights are on. Recognition lights should be always on. I mean, the moment we give some power to airplane, they should be on. We'll park here by the tower. Thank you, sir. Parking brake on. Let's shut down the engine. That's it. This is normal. Systems. No, no lights. We need sim options, ground power, Okay, and my door and cargo door to be cabin window shades. Let's see. This is without shades. And if we put shades. Oh, nice touch. Okay. I will put external view to this. And now you have to give me some time to enter the new flight plan. Okay, we're back and we're ready to continue our flight. Let's go back into the cockpit. And we can close cargo and main door. Also, we can delete this flight plan. Where is Q? Sarajevo. And our destination is Salzburg. Okay, for Sarajevo and departure, we are still using runway 11. Just a second. Yeah, when we take off, we go directly. Can we raise this? No. Runway 29er will not use. Any departure will go directly to Bosnia. And approach is runway 33. We only have Arnav. Let's use Arnav, runway 33, and load. And we have en route points. First is Bosnia. After Bosnia, we go direct to Oscar Mike Alpha. Then we have, yeah, sure. Oscar Mike Alpha, direct to Dolensko, Delta Oscar Lima. After Dolensko, we have Kilov Foxtrot Tango, Kilo Foxtrot Tango. Austria, okay. After that, we have Rasta. And after that, we have approach, or now approach to Salzburg. Okay, basically that everything. And geez, I will never learn, obviously. Initialization is done. Let's, we still have a one pilot, zero passengers, and now we have zero cargo. Fuel, we need 1,975 2,000. Let's see, how can we set up this? Sim options, load manager, yeah, one passenger, and we need. I did that initialization, so perform. Okay. Fuel. Now 1,900. We need exactly as we said. It seems that I will never learn, yeah? Sim options, yeah. Okay. Payload is okay. Get from sim 2,000, take off, next. Takeoff will have the same speeds. Okay. Back, sim options, actions. Yeah. So 3.5. Comma 3.5. Everything else is okay. Parking brake set on. Let's start engine number 2. We can ask to push us back. At least here. Let's start engine number 1. And let's just verify something if we have updated flight plan. Where are we? Here's Sarajevo. Yeah, we have updated flight plan. Oh, they're ready. Okay, you can push us. Oh, it has to be manually, yeah. Okay, thank you for your service. Recognition on, beacon on, navigation on, taxi off. I knew it. We need taxi lights on. Let's go. Oh yeah. FMS. Sarajevo traffic, Yankee Uniform 9 Town Hotel, taxiing to holding point, runway 11. Believe it or not, we are going to 40,000 feet. And now it's working perfectly, so I don't know what happened. Autopilot. We need this for takeoff. Yeah, nice. Sarajevo traffic, Kink Uniform 9 Town Hotel, entering runway 33 for backtrack for runway 11. Sarajevo. We are backtracking. That's enough. Sarajevo traffic, can you confirm that on hotel takeoff runway 11, Sarajevo?
Stall.
Still hang flying. We'll put a flight level change just so we can make correction. So we'll climb like 150 knots. It's warning us that yaw damper is off. Now we have yaw damper. Can engage autopilot. And start climbing. This point we are going direct Bosnia and it should intercept now Bosnia. Strobe beacon now, yeah, everything is fine. So bye bye Sarajevo. We need barometric pressure to 0 and this also to 113. I don't know why it didn't work as it was supposed to work at the beginning, but now it's working very nice. 40,000 feet. Unfortunately, all ATCs are offline and we'll have to fly alone. We went from Sarajevo. Salzburg. That flight shouldn't be that long. And hopefully we'll arrive there on time. Possible before dark. Let's increase our speed to 200 knots. Now we'll level up a little bit until we gain some speed, and after that we'll continue our climb. Let's go to maximum continuous thrust. So we are going further, already at 20,000 feet, we can increase our speed a little bit. Outside is very nice, so let us enjoy Bosnia for a while. Croatia, yeah. We are expected, currently, we're expected to be in Salzburg at in 2 hours, not 2 hours, sorry. We're expected in 6:18 Zulu, so it's 2 hours difference, so it's 8:18, in about an hour. about an hour we'll be in Salzburg. Let's follow a little bit how we're climbing. Not bad. At 30,000 feet we will go to Mach, and as we can see before exiting, Bosnia, we will be at 40,000 feet, which is not bad. Let's look at this wonderful plane from outside. As you can see, this plane represents correctly that we don't have a co-pilot. We are the only one. Let's go inside of the cockpit. We have, let's say, something around 5 to 6 minutes until we reach our top of climb. So we can make some noise. So let's verify. Flaps up, everything is fine. Outside temperature is minus 48 and we don't need the ice. We're well above clouds, and probably Cass will give us a notice that we have icing. Well, we're at our cruise altitude almost. Let's just help a little bit our airplane to achieve. What is going on now? This was actually my mistake. Again, it's a golden hour, but we'll land in approximately 40 minutes, which means that we'll probably land at dark. Speed up, and then we'll remove MCT. We're inside Croatia. Fluctuating is because of my joystick. Let's just see. Yeah, we have plenty of fuel. Okay, I just studied the meter for Salzburg a little bit, and the only thing that I can say is that it's not fun. Like current weather, we have like 25 knots gusting. Which is not very nice, but hopefully everything will be okay. We have like 7 minutes until top of the descent, and we are currently crossing Dolensko. Which means that we're in Slovenia. Let us prepare the charts for arrival. The runway that we will use is 15 by current meter. Chart to be pinned. Also arrival. That will use we'll leave it be. Let's just verify. Spin that chart also. And now we have to make some changes to our flight plan. We'll use ILS 15 and load that. And arrival will be Rasta to Romeo and load that also. Let's go to okay, we have approximately 1 minute. Start descending, and we are 109.9. Yep, 90. Transfer back. Let's start slowing down. Select altitude to something different. Let's see. At Rasta, we need to be above 12,000 feet, so we'll say 12,000. And engage VS. beats per minute, we'll leave it as selecting 12,000 feet, flight level 120. Let's go to 120. Come on, we can do it. We want to watch outside. Let's reduce a little bit. This we'll try to manage our speed for descent like this, and let us enjoy Slovenia. Ljubljana is left on our left side and currently way behind us. Let's see if we can see the wing view. No, unfortunately not, but it's somewhere there. We're in Austria already. Side should be something like Klagenfurt or something like that. We need to be flight level 120 or above, and on the next waypoint we should be 10,000 or above. Wonderful scenery and wonderful time. The weather is not wonderful because we'll have a, as I said, a gusting of 25 knots, and we have approximately 15 minutes to our destination. Actually, I never flew to Munich. that's something that I can probably do. Still see snow down there. Sunset. Anyway, as I was talking at the beginning of this flight, I'm planning a world tour. It should be fun. The only thing that I didn't thought of is actually airplane that I will be flying with. So there are two planes that I can fly. First one is TBM 930, and second one is this jet. I already flew with the TBM 850 around the world. Actually, I did it for a couple of times with different planes, but most fun I had with the TBM 850, and it was on X-Plane 11. And here, I don't know, I'm still picking between this plane, Honda Jet, and TBM. Which one will I choose? But we'll see. As much as I can see here, the weather is not very promising. So it's like stormy weather. I don't know if for real there is snow there, but maybe it is. Until we get down, I will mute myself for a moment and let you guys enjoy, and I will eat an apple. Actually, I didn't want to put the icing because I wanted to see if there is any ice accumulating on wings. Currently, I don't see that. So we will leave it be for now. Currently, we are following the profile, and everything is going according to plan. Approaching Salzburg. as you can see, we pick up some ice, which means that it's not enough. We have a windshield hit zone. It's not much. Let's see. Do we have any ice on the wings? No. On our we can go further. 8,000 feet. Or above, we'll set 8,000. Yes. And continue to descend. Maybe we will keep our speed around 200 knots, since this is a very bad weather that we are approaching. It's not showing that much, but it is. We're just passing our airport that we will land. Outside temperature is 3 degrees, but and we need the lights really. Landing lights on. Let's see outside view. Let's go inside the cockpit. What's going on? And after Rasta, we should follow SPG, not okay, the thing that I see is that we will need to fly this airplane manually. make a full turn. Because here on the map we have everything correctly. And approach. We didn't activate approach. Should be activated, but it's not. At least not the way we want it, so we are making a turn over Salzburg. Set FMS disconnect and go to VOR. Continue reducing our speed. We can even activate approach. Consult our charts. Four thousand feet. Okay. Our bank angle a bit. Oh, it's raining. Let's see if we can do this way. Contacted by ATC. And I think that our navigation system inside of airplane just died, probably froze to death. And we will go turn left to shorten this trip. Like this and continue. Welcome to the clouds. As you can see, we don't have any option in FMC. We'll continue our approach. Oh, we need to go down, not up. Let's put heading. Let's put out the pilot. What glide slope when we are like opposite of runway. Gospodine Topiću, kako ste, gospodine Topiću? I see that our radio also died. Poštovanje gospodine Topiću, nešto mi je poprljavio malo avion. Kako si?
Well.
Neka.
Bilo mi čudno da se ti ne javlja, zato sam se poslao poruku neko.
Me izbacio me sa Unicom. Salzburg traffic. Yankee Uniform 99 Hotel, turning base for ILS runway 15. Reactivated approach. In a few moments we'll start turning left. Trying to turn, but this nice simulator doesn't allow us. And we can start reducing our speed. Waiting for white arc, and let's go here and performance speedback landing. Get from simulator 107 approach 102 touchdown. I think that we captured localizer, maybe. We have some 13 nautical miles to runway, so we don't need to hurry too much.
Salzburg traffic on the 6 o'clock for turning right base 33. Neka, dobro, malo je kroz. Vidim, da, ja sam ti na milju i pol. Brzo ću ja to. Salzburg traffic, Tomcat 6 o'clock for gate 33.
Autopilot. Minimums. Five hundred. Four hundred. Three hundred. Two hundred. 100, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 5.
We are taxiing currently to General Aviation Parking, and we'll park there if there is any free space. I still don't know why our computer died, but we still managed to land to this airport pretty good. Okay, here we will go to General Aviation Parking and park somewhere. Are these gentlemen in t-shirts or they're dressed for the rain? It seems that they're okay. We'll go somewhere on the right side. Okay, let's put parking brake on and shut down this airplane. Okay, this everything is fine. Let's put some everything on normal. Back exterior lights, we did that. Interior lights, let's give us some light. Okay, this is nice. Oh, I could do this this way. Okay. This concludes our tonight's flight. I hope that you enjoyed it, even if at the end we had some issues. We'll put static elements on. And it's really lagging. Let's turn off ground power. We don't need anything online, so we'll shut down airplane and go to external view. So welcome to Salzburg. I hope that you enjoyed this flight. as much as I did. See you next time on the next flight. And hopefully bad weather is coming, so I suppose that I will test also TBM 930 in this kind of weather and see which one performs better. And according to that, decide which one I will use, because I really don't need in the mountains where the weather is bad, or a short runway or something like that. I don't really need airplane that will stop functioning. So that's it. Thank you for your time, and